Good morning, Hornet Nation. Welcome to the Daily Buzz. I'm Joe Hutzler. Today is February 26, 2018. Here's what the buzz is all about today. It was a very busy weekend for winter and spring sports, but we're going to begin with the final indoor meet for our winter sport, track and field, highlights from the ODAC Indoor Championships. These highlights brought to you by Bell's Automotive Services right here in Lynchburg, Virginia. Would be a great day to be a Hornet on the indoor track and field, a third place finish overall for the men and women when it was all said and done. Great shots from our crew all day long and great emotion showed by athletes and coaches, especially as the day moved along. So much so that our camera guy had a little bit of trouble keeping Natalie in this shot, but got it nonetheless, and she got a win, her first win of the indoor season, and that one coming in the way in the form of the 3,000 meter performance defeating Virginia Wesleyan. Casey Kalinowski set a personal record, not on this jump because he obviously knocked the bar down, but two jumps before that he made it, very happy about his performance, and a third place finish for Casey Kalinowski. And Deja Mitchell, one of five events for her on this pole vault right here. She wouldn't medal in this event, but she would medal later on in the day in two events, most notably her first career ODAC championship in the 400 meter dash. Congratulations to her. She also picked up a medal in the 4x4, the ladies with the second place finish in the 4x400 meter relay, and Xavier Kirtley helping his team to a third place finish, and on top of that, a rookie of the year performance for the freshman. Great day for the track and field squad. Also a good day for baseball down the street at Heritage High School, second day playing on the synthetic turf over there, thanks to Mother Nature, defoiling our plans as usual this time of year. First game against the Nittany Lions of Penn State Harrisburg, and it's a shot to left field by Matt Ward. Coming around third and second, it'll be Will Harris finishing out this run. 3-for-6 for him on the day, an RBI and a run in that first game, Lynchburg winning it 9-7. On to the second game in this doubleheader, Thomas Powell, beard power over the right field wall. His first home run of 2018, and he would help his team later on in the game too, going 2-for-3 at the plate. And also, great defense by number one. Check out this play. Michael Rice King, kind with the slow pitch and the slow throw from short to home. Kobe Purrier, can he hold on to it? Oh, it's creeping out. Oh, he got it. And the runner is out at home. Great connection from the freshman pitching it, and the freshman catching it and getting the out. And by the way, fellas, we got two outs. Later on in the game, Rice Kind with another pitch, and this one sent to deep left field. Getting back on it is Sean Allen. Allen makes the grab and hauls it in. Lynchburg, though, in the second game, falling to the Nittany Lions 5-2. Thomas Powell with that 2-for-3 performance. Their next game is Tuesday at 2 p.m. right here at Lynchburg College against the Monarchs of Methodist University. Other results from the weekend, a lot to get through here, so bear with us. Equestrian placed fifth in their hosting of their IHSA event, Christina Antonucci with the victory in open fences, and a victory for LHSN. Our first ever equestrian broadcast went very well, and we will also stream the ODAC event there in a few weeks. Moving on to women's tennis results, a 9-0 defeat over the Quakers of Guilford College to bring their record to 2-2. Sarah Wiley, Lily Altenberg, and Ellen Drubish with the 6-0 victories in singles. On the men's side, did not fare as well as they had liked to. Juan Borja with a singles win as well as Luke Sablik in that event, but the team losing 7-2. Going back to Saturday, also women's lacrosse falling to number 17, Mary Washington, 18-9. But Lynchburg scored 7 goals in that second half, so including hat tricks from Dory McGregor and Alicia Sandoval. So a great way to finish the game, and they're on the road for the next 5 events. They'll need to carry that momentum through with them on the bus to wherever they're heading next. Men's lacrosse drops their third straight game to start the season at Cabrini, who scored with 24 seconds left to get the win. Evan Lombardo with 6 points, 5 goals, and 1 assist on the day. And of course, softball, a big weekend for them. A doubleheader win over Maryville with a 7-5 victory. Home run and 3 hits for Jordan Vance. Plus, there's more. They also defeated Averett on the same day, and in walk-off fashion in the seventh inning, Mackenzie Chitwood with two runs and one hit, along with Leslie Bourgeois, last week's ODAC Player of the Week, one run and one RBI. Then on Sunday morning, that's right, 10 a.m., they battled the Phoenix of Wilson College to the tune of 8-2 victory, two runs and a hit for Jordan Vance, a great freshman start to her career here at Lynchburg College. And they finished off the weekend unblemished, 6-0 overall, 4-0 this weekend, 13-4 drubbing over the Bishops of North Carolina Wesleyan. Bourgeois again with another great performance, three RBIs on two hits. Let's move on to our only campus event today from 2 to 3 o'clock, undergraduate housing, 2018 to 2019 meeting at the Memorial Ballroom. If you're looking for a place to stay or need to know more information about your next location where you will sleep, then you need to check that out today from 2 to 3. As we do every day here on the Daily Buzz, we let you know what day it is on the National Day calendar. And today is National Pistachio Day, a snack that I don't like because it's too much work. However, if you have enough time to crack it open and take a bite, they're actually really good for you. They're heart healthy, they help fight diabetes, and also really good for weight management as well, for those of you still trying to stay on that diet you started back in the first day of January. That's all the time we have for today. Until tomorrow morning at 7 a.m. right here on Facebook.com/LynchburgSports. I'm Joe Hutzler, and this is the Daily Buzz. Remember, it's a great day to be a Hornet, and we are one nation.